Once again, welcome to IAS Business Academy webinars. Today's topic is a concept that we use actually in our finance module, and which is cash flow management. This is the topic of this webinar today. And then let me also introduce myself as we are moving forward. My name is Ersan, and I work for IAS Business Academy as an ERP training specialist. And today our guest presenter will be Johnson Varol, who is also an ERP training specialist under IAS Business Academy. So welcome, Johnson. How are you?
Welcome, Ersan. I'm fine. You?
I'm fine. Thank you very much for asking. So, Johnson, I would like to share some points for the success of this session, and then I will be back to you, get to know you much better.
Okay.
Okay, then. So let me just share some points before we start for the success of this webinar. The first one is, please always ask your questions during the webinar by typing to chat section that we have in the Zoom. So all the questions that you asked will be answered in the Q&A part, which we will have in the second session of this webinar. So microphones will be off during the webinar to avoid any kind of buzzing, any kind of noise in the webinar. So thank you very much for understanding for that. And then for those who are wondering, also this session is recorded and this session will be shared on Kanye's ERP YouTube channel afterward, after the webinar. And then we will be also sharing the record of this webinar on our website, which is www.iasbusinessacademy.com. And should you have any problems, you can share it through the chat section that we have in the Zoom, or email us directly, iba@kaniyascrp.com. And then you will receive a survey after the webinar. Please fill in the form to share what you think. We always value your ideas and contributions because those are always improving us. And let me also share the timetable for today for this webinar. So we started at 2 o'clock with Istanbul, Turkey time as planned. And today this webinar is also planned for 2 hours. And then now we are moving forward in the intro part, introduction section. And then after the intro part, and also after we get to know Johnson better, and then we will move forward with cash flow concept in the first section. And then we will be talking about cash flow in Kaniye's ERP and how we manage the cash flow. Then we will have a short break after we talked about cash flow in Kaniye's ERP. And then we will be moving forward with features of cash flow reports in the second section. And before we end the webinar, as we always do, we will have our Q&A section. So after I shared some points about the timetable of this webinar, I would also like to introduce IAS Business Academy to all participants. As the organizer of this webinar, IAS Business Academy, together with its new continuous improvement mission and with the new structure, keeps moving forward fast with a lot of projects. So this webinar is also one of the products of those projects. To summarize what we do in the Academy, IAS Business Academy provides a training for Kaniye's ERP, that is our main ERP software product, and the trainings are designed for both end users and expert users in order to minimize the issues that might be faced while switching to an ERP in a company. With the trainings, all the users become competent in using Kaniye's ERP in various ways so that they can start to work on Kaniye's ERP right away without losing even a second. Besides the module trainings that we have in the Academy, we also provide other trainings such as Full Cycle Digital Transformation, Troia, which is our own development platform, and also IAS DB, which is also our own database, Kaniye's IQ, and IoT, which allow a company to digitally transform and also institutionalize. So you can visit our website, which you can see on the presentation right now, and reach further information about our trainings, their content, and our training calendar. You can also submit your requests through our website or get in touch with us directly through iba@kaniyascrp.com email address. And you can also follow us on LinkedIn and Instagram to to see what we are doing in the academy. As I also mentioned earlier, the record of previous webinars and also this webinar, the record of this webinar, will be shared on the CRP YouTube channel as well as our IAS Business Academy website. After I introduced the IAS Business Academy, and then I would like to actually get to know better our guest presenter for today, Johnson Varol. So Johnson, can you please introduce yourself?
Hello everyone, I would like to say welcome to everyone and thanks for this opportunity to IAS Business Academy. I hope everyone is doing well. To get to know me, my name is Johnson Varol. I am an industrial engineer working in IAS Business Academy. And my career actually started while I was doing an intern scholarship in Czech Republic. It was a topic on production planning. So we were doing a project in C# language, and it made me lean on and softwares that are planning the production automatically. So then after graduating from university, I started my career into an intelligent transportation company as an ERP consultant. I was responsible for modules such as production, finance, budget. And now I'm working in IAS as a training specialist, and also I am teaching the modules such as finance, production, budget, asset modules, and I'm responsible for these modules. So in my private life, I like to do sports. It's my hobby. So that's in summary.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much, Johnson, then.
You're welcome.
So before we go ahead with the cash flow concept, actually, I have a question to the audience, and then I will just turn off my screen sharing, and then you can start right away. So as we are doing right now, as an interactive part of our webinars, I would like to ask you a question to the participants. Now, let me just share it. Yes. So now you will see a pop-up screen. Please answer the question, and then we will start with the cash flow concept with Johnson Varol. It will probably take a minute to complete this short survey. Okay, the answers are coming. Okay, let's give 10 seconds more, and then I will just end this polling. Okay, thank you very much for your participation. Now the polling has just ended. Okay, thank you very much. And now I'm just turning off my screen sharing, and then please have your say, Johnson.
Okay, I'm sharing my screen. I think now everyone is seeing my screen.
Yes, yes, Johnson, okay. We can. Yeah.
Okay, once again, I would like to say welcome to everyone. In this pandemic process, I hope everyone is doing okay. And thanks for the technology. We are doing this webinar through this software. So it's very good to be with you. And today's topic is cash flow, as you all know. I will be introducing the cash flow concept to you. I will define what is cash flow, what are the benefits of cash flow, why we are using the cash flow, and what are the good or bad cash flows. And then we will continue with Kania CRP cash flow reports. And then I will take your questions. So I just want to simply define what is cash flow. As you may all know, cash flow is a so important topic for our business to run and get revenues. So cash flow refers to the revenues as a business generates actually. It can be collects as well. Compared to the expenses, it pays out over a fixed period of time. So it's placed according to the time intervals. As we want to broad speakingly, business bring in money through sales or in other channels like financing, or it can be returns on investment even. And they also spend money. So while business is getting money, they also spend money on supplies, services, as well as utilities or taxes, other bills, wages for employees, and rent, even the rent of the company, the building that we pay rent. So on the left side, there are revenues, and on the other side, there are expenses that company pays. And cash flow refers to the movement of the money in and out. So in our business, there is a money going in and out in terms of income and expenditure. So ideally, if we want to have positive cashback, that means we want to have the money inside, coming inside, to be higher than the money we spent, actually, the cash out. So that means the positive cash out, if we have money coming more than the money spent, that means we have positive cash flow. So our business will be able to settle the bills, investments, growth. And if we have a negative cash flow will be meaning that we need to find an alternative source of income. The current income is not sufficient enough so that we will able to pay off the debts and all other expenses. So we can simply define what is cash flow like this. So cash flow is like a historical topic. We see the examples in the of cash flow in history. For example, this is a picture from early 19th century. It's a German ledger. So a German company was using to calculate its cash flow through this paper. So now in our date, we have advanced softwares that are doing these calculations for us. So this is a very good picture that I found on the web. It explains what is cash flow, what is the inflow in cash flow, and what is the outflow in the cash. So as you see in the picture, if we see the cash as a water, and if we think this tank is the cash in our hand, we are filling the tank with the water, with cash. So there is a cash flow coming to our tank. That can be coming from different sources of income, such as revenue from sales, or collections from checks, payments, collections from customers. Like you can think of any source of income. It can be investment coming from our investment. And also we have cash in our hand. So this cash inflow increases our cash in hand and fills the tank. So that means if we have cash in hand higher than cash outflow, our company is doing well, actually. On the other hand, if we look at the right side, we have cash outflow. We have cost of production, wages, taxes, the building that we are running our company, we pay rent. You can think about any other sources, vendor payments that can be cash outflow. So the money is going as well. So we need to see the big picture in the cash flow report. We need to see the big picture and we need to take preventive actions to increase cash in hand and to increase the cash inflow and to minimize the cash outflow, actually. This is the main aim of the cash flow report. So companies are asking these questions. How much money will I have in a chosen time of period? The company should know this money, amount of money that they will have in a specific time interval, how much money I have in cash, how much outflow from my cash will I have, how much inflow in a specific time of period I will have, so that they can compare the inflow and outflow, and they can calculate the cash in hand, so that the cash flow helps the company to see future payments and future inflows. So we talk about cash inflows and outflows. In our software, we have a cash flow report as well. So this is an example picture that shows what can be the inflows for a cash flow. In our software, we use nearly all of the inflows that a person can think, such as cash, checks collected from customers, as well as vouchers and customer collections that made through the sales module, also included in the cash flow report, and also some items that are not calculated through the finance documents can be entered as plan values. Also forward collections and financial documents that can be that might be integrated into cash flow can be entered via our system. If we talk about cash outs, it can be vendor payments, check payments that we pay to the vendors, voucher payments. These are different payment methods that we made to vendors, or credit payments. Some companies, nearly most of the companies, are using bank credits. So bank credits has three types of, in our financial accounting standards, three types of expenses. So we need to see these expenses in our cash flow report as well. Letter of credit payments, if we have plan values, again, plan values was in cash in and cash out reports. So we can enter plan values. I am planning this amount of money to spend in this related interval of time. Also forward payments and financial documents. I will talk about these subjects in the next slides. It can be our cash outflows. Yes, there is a question that we'd like to ask to our participants.
Okay, yeah. So now we have a question about the concept of cash flow. So I will be launching the poll once again right now. So let me just select the question and launch it. Okay, so now we have a question to the all participants. So what do you think about this? So how many percent can it be? According to the US bank study, blah, 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 percent of business failures are due to poor cash flow management or poor understanding of how cash flow contributes to the business. So there's a percent that we are asking right now. Please answer accordingly. And then Johnson will continue with the answer and also its description. So I think this question will also provide us a perspective about how important the cash flow is in a business or any kind of business. Okay, let's give 10 seconds more before I end this poll. Okay, the answers are still coming. Please answer the percent that you think. Okay, the answers are still coming. I'll just allow you to answer more. Okay, in 3, 2, 1, and okay, now the polling has just ended. Now I will be sharing the results. So now you can see the results on your screen as a pop-up screen. So, okay, Johnson, please have your say about the results.
Yeah, I think most of our participants answered correctly.
Yeah.
Very good. This is a scientific research done in USA that shows the correct answer is 82%. That shows how important to have a correct cash flow report, actually. If we have failed doing our cash flow report, that means most likely in this research is it's 82%, our business will fail. So as we see, this report is so important for our company to run its business correctly and efficiently. All other modules like sales, production, purchase, providing data to finance, and from the finance, we are using such reports, cash flow, and all other reports. We are commenting, we are analyzing this number of reports that made our business run. So here, as we see, the answer is 82. That shows this cash flow report. It's so important for our business, and we need to be carefully building the reports and its headers and items, and correcting all data provided to this cash flow report. So as we continue, this is a presentation for our finance, how our finance is working. But I don't want to focus on all finance modules. I want to focus on cash flow. If you look at right upside, you will see the cash flow square. And that shows, this graphic shows, which data, which modules are integrated with cash flows. Actually, I mentioned about cash in and cash outs. So here, as we can see, cash flow is integrated with financial documents management, financial documents. Financial documents, it's in the center of this picture, which means most likely all of the modules are producing financial documents, and also sub-modules in finance are producing financial documents. So cash flow basically reads these finance documents to run a report. But which modules are creating documents, financial documents? We can see investment management, bank credits. Bank credits are creating financial documents. So through financial documents, we can build, we can get data from bank credits and analyze our cash flow report, actually. And also, we see other sub-modules, such as chart of accounts. It's an important transaction in our system as well. By defining detailed chart of accounts, we can analyze our cash flow report. We can run it correctly. And also matching and debiting closing transactions, recurring payments on the left side, and check voucher, letter of assurance commissions can also provide data to cash flow. We will be also focusing this sub finance transactions. How do they provide data? What is the importance of these transactions? Why do we define it? And why it's important to filter such as this data and run our cash flow report. In Kania CRP cash flow report, as I mentioned in the previous slide, uses nearly all of the modules and gets data from these sub transactions in the finance. As you see on the screen, plan values I mentioned about. Plan values, I will be giving detailed information in the next slides. We can enter data that is not planned in our finance and that has no financial document, can be entered into our cash flow report. So this is an important feature. Also, alternative payment plan can be entered through the transactions. That basically shows this customer will pay us in this alternative paying scenarios, and we can take into consideration that this payments according to their due date will be placed into our cash flow report. Also, recurrent finance items, that means like recurring financial expenses such as rent or taxes that we pay in a specific time interval in every month, like food card installments, or it can depend on any other company. We are integrating these recurrent finance items to the finance via transactions, and we can see this data in our cash flow as well. Orders and sales from sales and purchase transactions also plays important role in our system, because we may receive a big amount of sales in through the system, through the sales module, and we might be able to see it in our cash flow. In this specific time interval, I will receive this amount of cash flow. So I need to see it as a cash inflow in my cash flow report. Also, purchases that we made should be expenses. So I might be able to see it as an expense that I purchased this order. For example, 2 months later, I will purchase this material. So I need to be able to see it in my expenses according to its due date. Some companies may be using letter of assurance. If you know about letter of assurance concept, there is a commissions paid in installments. For letter of assurance, we can also integrate these commission expenses in our cash flow so that we also see it with other expenses. Also, bank credits plays important role in our system. We have a bank credit transaction. And with bank credits, you may have more than one bank credit. That means in 1 month, you may be paying more than one installment for different credits. So this is an expense for you, and you might be able to see it in your cash flow report as well. So these all six transactions are providing data to our cash flow report, actually. Some of them are going to cash inflow. Some of them are going to cash outflow. But at the end of day, when we look at the big picture, we see the inflow and outflow so that we see the cash in hand from the report. Actually, in the basis of our system, everything is defined in the chart of accounts. For example, this is a checks, vouchers in portfolio chart of accounts. Here, if you look at the left side of the screen, there is a definition for cash flow, fin transaction 50 and fin transaction 51. So you can define this account in your cash flow that will be seen under check collections bank header in fin transaction 51. So we are defining our accounts according to where they will be seen in our cash flow report. So as we see on the screen, we also have two cash flow reports, which I will be explaining in the next slides. Through these financial accounts, users are creating financial documents, actually. In every financial document, in the rows, there are financial accounts. So if we defined the cash flow value type in these accounts through the financial account and through the financial documents, it will be able to see it in our cash flow report. So I might say this is the basic of how our cash flow report is working through the definitions in the account in chart of accounts. Yeah, plan values for cash flow was a transaction in our system. In this transaction, we define some plan values that will come to our cash flow report. But actually, in real life, in our financial document transaction in our system, there is no such a data exist here. We just define the plan values that will be coming to our cash flow report according to their due date. As you see on the screen, there are six plan values defined for this for our cash flow. Some of them are like other income, some of them are like tax payment, which is cash out. So we define the amount and we define the account number, but in financial documents there is no such data exists. So these are just plan values, but it will be seen in our cash flow report. So this is an important and like good feature in our system, that user can define plan values, plan income, plan outcome values into the system, so that the system uses these values and shows in the cash flow report. Also, in these definitions, user can relate this amount with project and cost center relation. So in project and cost center transaction, they might be able to see the total cost of the project. So this is how we define plan values for cash flow. As you see on the left side, we define the account number due date that will be placed into our cash flow report and the amount of this plan value. So in this example, this is a tax payment. It's written in the description field. And on the other side, user can define if it is debit or credit, or if it is like a credit limit or tax refund or tax payment. It's up to user. These fields can be modified. It shows the status of these plan values. So from this definition, this data, this amount, posting amount, will go to cash flow report. Alternative payment for cash flow. As you know, we made our sales from the sales transactions. So in sales transactions, there is a payment plan defined for each sales. But different than this payment plan, customer may pay this money in different scenarios. In this transaction, we define different payment, alternative payment scenarios for these customers, for any chosen customer. For example, there is an invoice that we created for this customer, and this customer, although it's just one payment in the sales document, we can define an alternative payment this customer will pay us in three installments in total. And for each installment, although he didn't make any payment, we need to see it in our cash flow report, because this payment will come according to their due date, even though they didn't pay, but they will pay eventually. And we might be able to see it in our cash flow report placed in the due date columns. So here, predicted payment scenarios can be entered. Customer pay more than one time. They can pay three installments, one installment, two. It's up to users. But you may ask the question, like, once it's matched with the real payment, this alternative payment plan will not be considered in our cash flow report. Once the real payment made, system will take the real payment as a value in our cash flow report. So as you see in this picture, I use the alternative payment plan in our cash flow. There is a checkbox for use alternative payment plan. So if I check this checkbox, user will be able to see the alternative payment plan for this customer collection. But once this customer made the real payment, system will not take this alternative payment plan values. So this is the first picture of our cash flow report. Actually, I will be mentioning about the details and fields and all other fields. But if you see in the middle side, there are some filters, some checkboxes that use alternative payment, use recurrent payments. So user can compare the cash flow with using alternative payment plan or without using alternative plan through these checkboxes. Recurrent payment items for cash flow. So what is recurrent payment items? They are like rent, tax, or any other expenses that we made every month. Every month I'm paying rent for my company. I am paying some tax, or also I'm installing money for my employees into their food carts, or you can think about other examples. So this is a recurring payment items transaction. Through this transaction, we can enter recurring items and we can integrate them to the finance. That means we can create financial documents from these transactions. And also the most important feature is that through these documents or through this table, the plan values that I will pay, for example, for November, for October, I will pay this amount of rent, this amount of tax. So I need to see it in my cash report, actually. Even though I didn't pay yet, I need to see this amount placed into relevant due date. So here you can create any rent payments, and you can integrate payments when the date is come. You can integrate it to the finance just by one click, and you can see the amounts in your cash flow report placed into due date columns. It's an efficient transaction to use it because you might want to see how much money you will pay for these recurrent items into chosen time of cash flow report. This is how we integrate our finance recurrent items and how we see them in one structure, in one transaction, actually. In the previous slide, we created our recurrent items, and in this transaction, we may see it and we may integrate it to the finance. We can create financial documents for these recurrent items. And even though I didn't integrate to the finance, for example, rent 2020, November, I will be seeing this amount of money in my cash flow report. So as you see, 10,000 euro recurring payment is placed into my cash flow report. In previous slide, it was 10,000 lira, as you see. And when I check the checkbox "Use recurrent payments," system calculates the amount of this recurrent payment. For example, it was a rent, and place this rent payment amount into relevant due date columns for every month: July, August, September, and November. So even though I didn't pay this rent, I will be seeing this amount of money as a payment in my cash flow report. But once you again create financial document, made this payment in real life and create financial document integrated to the finance, system will not be showing this amount of money in payment header item types. So this transaction give us a more precious information in terms of cash out. And every payment placed into due date columns, and also recurring payments can be seen in cash flow, and you can run different cash flows with recurrent payments or without recurrent payments. And orders for cash flow. By orders, I mean purchase orders and sales orders, actually. These orders like very important for our company because we made sales, and through the sales we get money, and we purchase some materials, some stuff, and we pay money to vendors. So orders plays important role in our system, even though we didn't integrate to the finance, even though we didn't create any invoice, we may see it in our cash flow report. Purchase orders, for example, before invoice pays, that means before integration to the finance, that is, there is an order created from vendor that we are purchasing something. That means the possible cash outflow from our cash can be seen in the cash flow. So this money will be cash out for my company, and I might be able to see it in my cash flow report. Also, purchase orders, again, everything is placing according to due date. What is my due date for this purchase order? System will place this purchase orders amount into relevant due date column in my cash flow report. As well as purchase orders, system also thinks about sales order as well, because through the sales order we will create sales invoice and sales invoice will create financial document that will be real money, real revenue from sales come to my cash in hand. But before these phases, sales order before invoice phase should be seen in the cash flow, because this is a possible sales invoice for me. I will receive this money after sales invoice. I will receive this money, but company should be able to see the sales order amount before invoice phase, that this money will come as a sales revenue to our company. So system once again places this amount in our cash flow report, and I can check the checkbox use orders for cash flow in any desired time period for this cash flow. Another transaction in our finance, letter of assurance. We have a transaction that user can enter letter of assurance, and what we are focusing on this transaction is actually the commissions of this letter of assurance. Once we create the letter of assurance, this will be given assurance, because we are giving letter of assurance to some subcontractor or some project owner that we will be doing this job for you. So this is my letter of assurance from bank. So by giving this letter of assurance, banks are charging some commissions. And these commissions, although I didn't pay yet, these commissions are like future payments for me. For each given letter of assurance, there is a commission. The number of commissions are depending according to banks, but there is a commission. So in this screen, we can see that this letter of assurance has three commission items, and the amount is 2,500 euro. And this commission will be paid in future months, but I will be able to see it in my cash flow report thanks to the feature that checking letter of assurance commission checkboxes. So this is the screen where we enter the details of letter of assurance, and as I mentioned before, there is a commissions where we can enter commission amounts, commission dates. On the bottom side of the dialog, the user can enter how many commissions they will pay, and once they enter this commission amounts, they will be able to see it in our cash flow report. So as you see, on the top side of the screen, the user can check the filter use commissions of letter of assurance. So this 2,500 euro commission from a letter of assurance will be placed according to its due date. So this, its due date, it's in this example, it's August. So this 2,500 euro is placed to the August month column and can be seen in the cash flow as an cash out. In the previous transaction, we can track our letter of assurance, and by integration to the finance, again system will remove this amount of money from this cash out. Yeah, bank credits. We have a transaction for bank credits. Actually, like most of the people are having bank credits nowadays, as well as persons, citizens, companies are also taking credits from banks. They are taking credits in huge amounts. So that means a very big amount of money in each installment. User can enter bank credits, different type of credits, for example, equal 12 month credit, or monthly interest paid credit, or rotary credits. We have different type of credit types in our system. User can enter different type of credits into system and This transaction will be creating the payment plan automatically from the interest rate and all other installment days, monthly or weekly, depending on the user or bank. System will create the initial payment plan automatically just by one click. User can pay this amount of money from this transaction, also integrated to the finance, which means creating financial documents just by clicking one button actually. What I want to focus in this transaction actually is that we can see the future payments. For example, in 2021, I see credit installment payments in this plan. So this is a fictive payment, like it's a future period payment. I haven't done this payment yet, but I will be paying this amount of money. So user should see this money in the cash flow, because this will be cash out for the company. Once we take the credit amount will be cash inflow to our bank or cash, but the installments with interest, fund and tax for Turkish accounting standards, it might change in different countries' accounting standards. The payments for installments will be cash out for my report. So user should be able to see this cash outflows through this bank credit transaction. And also generated credit plans can be seen in the relevant due dates. Once again, for each installment, we see this payment in the relevant due date column in our cash flow report. So in this example, a user took 400,000 euro credit with annual interest rate 12, and system created initial plan automatically from the credit type equal to amount credit. And this amount of monies, like for example, I see 30 something amount of principal to be paid in every month for each installment. User will be able to see this amount of money in the cash flow. So if you go to next slide, in our company financial settings check table, we also defined on the right side of the dialog, we defined credit principal amount and account and credit interest account, credit tax accounts, so that these tax and fund accounts will be seen in our cash flow. Credit expenses can be in different accounts. It's up to customer and it's up to their accounting standards. It can be in different accounts. But user can switch to any desired account from these check tables. Chart of accounts and company financial settings are made for credits in cash flow. So once we are defining these accounts will be used for these expenses, system automatically checks this, check the details of this account and place any expense subject to this bank credit into relevant due date column. So once again, if I switch back to cash flow report, there is a filter again, use credit values. If I check this checkbox, as you see in the credit payments on the left folder, credit payments, system plates place 35,990 euro credit payment into August column. So credit expenses can be seen in the relevant period, once again according to due date. For this payment, the due date was August, so system placed this credit payment into August column. And credit payments have a big role in cash out, because we talk about huge amount of money that we pay every month. So we should take into consideration that this money will be cash out from our cash, and we might want to see it in our cash flow report. User can see future payments, no matter how many credits have been using in the company. So system will sum up the number of credits and sum up the installment for the relevant month and place into relevant column according to due date, no matter how many credits our company using. So once again, this is an interactive report. If I click on the amount of credit in credit payments, 35 something thousand euro, system is showing which expenses caused this money on the bottom side of the screen. So there is the four account that creates this amount of money, and user can see this accounts. For example, 780 bank credit tax expenses, bank credit fund expenses, and interest expenses that we defined in our cash flow in our company financial settings subject to this credit payment. So we saw some sub transactions in the finance module, and we saw how do they provide data into our cash flow. And we also see plan values, which helps us to define any predicted cash value for our cash report. And all other modules actually are providing real data. But in some cases, we may want to not see the specific financial document or specific account in our cash flow. So in these circumstances, what we do is simply go into detail of the desired financial document that we don't want to see in our cash flow report. And on the screen, I indicated with square, there is an option, cash flow checkbox. Also, there is an option on the left side, not used in cash flow. So up to user can choose this financial document will not be used in any circumstance and will not be seen in the cash flow report, so that he or she can check this checkbox, not used in the cash flow, and this document will not be seen in the cash flow. But in any time, any specific time, user can change back to default settings and can check, uncheck the not using cash flow checkbox, and later he or she will be able to see it again in the cash flow report. So we can do this settings in any financial document actually. Any exclusion can be defined for a financial document in the system, as I show you here. And financial documents, any financial documents separated from all other transactions that I talked before, any financial document can be seen in the cash flow. If user check this cash flow checkbox, it will be seen with the amount and with the due date in the relevant due date column in our cash flow report. So also in the financial document, there are items which contains the account numbers, and a system user also have to define this, have to define cash flow item types for each account if he or she wants to see this amount in the cash flows. Yeah, also some documents, for example, purchase or sales invoices may contain payment conditions. What is payment condition? Simply defines in which date and how much payment amount we are going to make or we will receive from customer. So payment condition simply defines the payment, number of payments, and number of amount of payments. In any case, if in the financial document is there a, if there is a different number of payments will be made by customer or we are going to make to vendors, system will take into consideration that these dates, these payment dates and this payment amount will be placed according to their due dates. Due date in this case is payment date. They will be placed into relevant due date in our cash flow report. So with this feature, actually we see that no matter how many payment condition user defines in the system, system automatically places in every payment amount and every payment date into relevant due date column in our cash flow report. So for example, if payment will be made with 3 installments, it is defined in the sales or purchase document, and this information will be transferred through the sales document to our financial document, and cash flow report will take this amount, will take this date and place it into relevant due date column. So we see the integration with payment conditions, different payment conditions, and how cash flow report reacts to these different payment conditions. Yeah, if you want to talk about the features of cash flow, so far I mentioned how cash flow report is working, where it gets data from, but also it has some important features, useful features inside this transaction. For example, the report currency, user can take cash flow into any desired currency. If it is defined in the system, system will convert into any amount into report currency. For this example, the report currency is euro. Also, there is a document currency filter. System user can only filter specific document currencies. For example, use only dollar or euro documents in my cash flow. Only take that documents that contains euro or dollar currency. So cash flow will be filtering the documents and taking only the specific chosen document currency from the user. User can take the cash flow data range on the left top of the screen. There is a date, month, and week radio buttons. So system user can take the cash flow in months, for example, between 2020 6 months and between 2020 12 months, end of the year. User can take the cash flow report in a monthly base, or user can take the report in weekly base, for example, get me this week's, or any specific date range. If we switch back to date, user will be able to choose days in a month, and will be able to choose again the end of the date range as a day. Also, we see a detail type combo box near to date range columns. With this detail type, user can take report for any specific date range. User can say, get me this detail date range in weeks, but other date range, it can be in months. For example, in this example, user choose detail as range between 6 and 7 months. System will show the report in weeks, in week type. But other date range from 7 month to 12 month, system will show the amounts into months. So system user can take any specific date range as a week column, and all other date range separated from this range will be shown in months. Also, we can include, as we mentioned about, we can include plan values, alternative payment plan, recurrent payments, commission of letter of assurance or credit values, and we cannot use. So it's up to user again. User can take the cash flow with these values or without these values. And on the top side, top right side of the screen, there are some checkboxes. Says the report that you will be using these headers. For example, ready, check collection, bill collection, customer collection. These headers shown, indicated with folder icons, is predefined by our developer team so that the company can just take these folders and define their financial account under these folders. So this is a preset folder structure that we provide to the user in this transaction. Also, we are providing to the users that you can build your own structure. You can build your own folders with a tree structure. You can define subfolders, main folders. Under main folders, you can define unlimited amount of subfolders. So you can simply build your tree structure through the check tables. But in this transaction, we are giving the folder view, the structure, just included in the transaction. But it's also, again, up to user. User might say, I don't want to use bill payments, or I don't want to use plan values. So user can simply uncheck the related checkbox, and he or she will not see the folder that predefined in the system. So it's up to user again. Also, this report, cash flow report, is working cell based. What it means that if I click on a specific cell, system will show me, for example, if I click on any cell that contains amount, system will show me the details of this amount, which financial documents, under financial documents, which financial accounts caused, created this amount in this cell. So user, if you want to see the detailed information of the cell, he can just click on the cell, and system will show the related account through the financial documents on the bottom side of the screen. Yeah, another important feature is rate convert type. If there is any foreign currency rates in the report, user can exchange the rate chosen by combo box, such as purchase, sales effective purchase, or effective sales rate, or any specific rate conversion date. User can define the rate conversion date. For example, user want to see the exchange rate from a previous specified time period, so he or she can enter any specified rate conversion date into the report rate conversion date field, and system will automatically take that conversion rate and convert any foreign document with the currency date entered in the conversion date column. Yeah, we mentioned about report currency. User also can take the cash flow report for different business areas. Also, if there is more than one company running in this ERP system, user can take a one consolidated cash flow report from multiple chosen companies. So I can choose more than one companies, basically. Yeah, simply we defined every field in the report, actually. So here, as you see, system user can click on any folder, and system will automatically will show the subfolders under this main folder. Again, cash flow item type defined in every account, in account chart of accounts. Cash flow item type indicates that this account will be shown in this folder. So user can change the folder for a specific chart of accounts in any time. Subtransaction values from finance, sales and purchase, such as plan values and alternative payments, can be seen and not seen depending on the user's choice. This is the second cash flow report. In the first report, we give the folder view, we give the tree structure predefined inside the transaction. But if it is not suitable for the company or user wants to build his own structure, his own field, they can define this structure, they can create these folders in the grids, they can create these folders and they can create subfolders under these main folders through the check tables actually. So it's up to user which cash flow report they will be using. They might choose our predefined cash flow report, or they might choose to build their own structure and they will want to create folders one by one, and they might want to define every subfolder under these main folders. So we call it item type structure. Actually, this is built by user, and also same logic applies here. Inside every detail of chart of accounts, there is a cash flow item type defined for each account, so that system will be placing these accounts into relevant folders here. This is how you define folders actually. In the previous slide, there are like three folders: cash, cash inflow, and cash outflow. But in every folder, there is a subfolder. I will be showing you the pictures. For example, under cash inflow, here user can define cash, cash in and cash out, but under cash there are different types of subfolders. For example, ready, cash, bank, etc. And cash in, for example, foreign customers, customers to and customers, these are subfolders defined in the main cash in folder. Also, it applies same in cash out folder. User defined vendors, F vendors, foreign vendors or domestic vendors, with shown with D, and this will be seen under cash outflow. So as we switch back to search plus tab in the report, this is like a bit advanced from the previous predefined structure report. Here user can see sales document, sales invoice, sales delivery, sales order, or even scheduling agreement. For purchase module, user can see purchase invoice and purchase order, but in the previous report it was till orders for purchase orders, and for sales orders it was till order phase. But in this report, user can take the report in sales invoice base or even in sales delivery. So again, the using of plan values, credit values, or alternative payment values on the top of left screen is same with the previous report actually. User can uncheck this checkbox and take report with not using plan values, not using alternative payment, or with using. So this is the tree structure opened by user. So if I double click on cash outflow folder, for example, user defined in check tables that the vendors folder is under this cash outflow folder, and under this vendor folder there is a folder created named by domestic vendors. So these documents, for example rent payments, is placed under this domestic vendor folder. And in the first row there is a cash folder, and under cash folder there is a ready subfolder. So these are user defined folders, is different than predefined tree structure cash flow report. User here defined his own structure and run the report in his defined structure type. So again, related documents in each header can be seen. If I choose any specific cell, system will show me the related document that provides data on the bottom side of the screen. Also in the options tab, there is a grouping criteria, which is a very important feature for this report. User can run the report in a project grouping criteria or business or any cost center that is subjected to these accounts will be grouped by in same cost centers. Also, there is an account and material grouping criterias, and there is detail show type. It can be group header and documents, or it can be only headers. It's up to user again. User might want to see the related documents under these folders, so he will choose group header and documents. Or if he wants to just see the headers, he or she doesn't want to see the details of the header, he doesn't want to see the documents related to these folders, they can just simply choose group header option from the combo box actually. And in data column type, it simply indicates the name length of the date column for each month, June, July, August. It can be in medium short range or long short range, which is the full word corresponding to July, August, September, or October, or it can be seen under values 06, 07, 08. Yeah, user can define some documents to not use or use in the cash flow by not going to financial document transaction, but choosing this button. Under functions button, there is an option, use not use documents in the cash flow report. So the user might want to see the some documents will be excluded from the cash flow report. So he or she will be go to this section and define which financial documents will not be in this cash flow report. So there is a shortcut button. A user can get the report excluding any document by choosing from functions button. And yeah, we were talking about table view only so far. But is it possible? It's possible that user can export this data to any outsource with any desired file format, such as PDF, Excel file, or any other file format, or a system user can get the graphic data, for example, pie chart, bar chart, or other various reporting graphic formats. System user can take the cash flow report in a graphic view and can print it and can apply any desired filters in this chart view. Actually, it was all I was going to explain so far. So thanks for listening to me.
Okay, thank you very much, Johnson. I think now your presentation actually is completed. So please stop sharing your screen. Then I will be going ahead with mine. So now we are in the QA part. If you have any questions, as I also mentioned a few times in the chat section as well, if you have any questions, please share them. And then we will be answering them in the QA section. Okay, let's give them a few minutes to think about and ask. Otherwise, we will go ahead with the presentation, also with the webinar, through the end. Yes, we are waiting for the questions if you have any. Okay, I think there's a question right now from Jayesh. In finance documents, there is or that which option cash flow consider?
Yeah, should we answer now or wait for other questions?
No, please go on.
Okay, very good question actually. So if we think about a sales document that created through the sales module, there might be payment conditions applied to this document, and this data is transferred to the finance document. So in this case, there will be payment date. It might be more than different date according to payment condition, and there will be due date. So normally, if it is only one due date information, customer will pay the amount of money until this due date. And system will place this amount according to the due date column in the cash flow report. But if there is any payment condition applied in the financial document as well through the sales document, then system will take into consideration this payment condition and this payment dates and amounts. So if there is any more than two payments, there will be two payment dates and two payment amounts. So system will place these amounts according to their due date in our cash flow report.
Okay, thank you very much, Johnson. Okay, another question right now. Okay, so how is the relationship of budget updates based on the cash flow management outcomes? So it actually asks the relationship between the budget module and also the finance documents as well as the cash flow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is a connection between budget and cash flow report. We can create a cash flow for our budget actually from budget values.
Mm-hmm.
We can create cash flow report. We have a different module for budget, as you may all know maybe.
Mm-hmm.
We provide data, sales, production, purchase, investment, expenses, and we create a budget for our company. And then from this budget, from this data, we create our cash flow for only this budget. But the cash flow, budget cash flow, might be different than the real cash flow seen in the screen. So user might want to compare the difference of these two cash flows. And then a user will check the use budget checkbox in the cash flow and we'll be able to see the data from coming from budget modules and compare it.
Okay, thank you very much, Johnson. And another question. If the sales order document is partial status, will the cash flow consider the proportionate value?
Yes, it will consider. No matter what is the status, if we check the use orders checkbox in the cash flow report, system will take the amount of the purchase or sales order,
mm-hmm.
No matter what, and we'll place the amount into relevant due date column.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much. So, okay, we are still in the QA part. If you have any questions, please share them through the chat section that we have in the Zoom. And you can also share your feedbacks if you have any, or about the answers, actually, that we provide. You can also share your feedbacks. Okay, let's give our participants a few minutes and then we will go ahead with closing this webinar. Okay, another question. What happens if a cash flow which directs to company wrongly is created. So what happens if we create a wrong cash flow?
Yeah, then the first step will be the finding which financial document and which account caused this wrong cash flow. So they will be focusing on these financial documents and they will be fixing the details of the account. They will be defining different cash flow item type in the detail of the account, and they will be fixing it simply.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, it is very important to define correct and accurate cash flow item types in every account in the chart of accounts so that they will be placed into correct header folders in our cash flow report.
Okay. Yeah, I think this question is also related with what you explained in the first session, in the very beginning of the session. So why cash flow management is important for a business or for a company. So therefore, it should be considered very wisely yes, for the success of the business in general. Okay. So, okay, we are still waiting for the questions. Let's give a few minutes more. And then if you don't have any other questions, then we will go ahead with closing this session for today. Okay, I think all the questions are these ones, so that's all for now. So let's go ahead with the next week, actually. Not the next week, next month, actually, with the IBA on Zoom webinars. So in the following webinar, so which will take place in the 11th of August, so it will be organized in the next month, in the second week of August. And our topic for the following webinar is KVKK processes. So which is KVKK is the GDPR for Turkey, let's say, for those who don't know what KVKK is. So it will be about actually GDPR processes in Turkey. And this webinar will also be in Turkish. Ceren Dalar, who is the standardization quality manager of IAS Turkey, will be the presenter for the next week. And also our corporate lawyer, Gökçe Sufrat, will be with us in the next webinar. And then if you just have a look at the general of August webinars in IBA on Zoom, after the GDPR processes, and then we will have another finance webinar, and it will be about loan management concept, again in the finance module. And this webinar will be also in Turkish, and Aykut Eğileten, who is a software development specialist in finance modules, will be with us presenting finance module and loan management concept. So we will have only two webinars in August, as you can see right now. And thank you very much for your participation. Now we have just come to the end of this webinar. Hope to meet you actually once again in the following one, in the 11th of August 2020, again at 2 o'clock. Please don't forget to check your inbox after this webinar, because as I mentioned in the beginning, you will receive an email for your thoughts and for the next webinars, actually. And I would like to wish you all a healthy day. And I invite you to open your cameras to take a screenshot before we end this webinar. Now I will just stop my screen sharing, and please, those who would like to participate in this, open your cameras, and then I will just take a screenshot before we end the session. Then we will close this webinar for today. Okay, now the cameras are coming. Thank you very much. Let's give them a few seconds more. And by
thank
the way,
you everyone, okay, for joining. I would like to thank you everyone. And if you have any questions detailed, I might be able to reply via email or Skype or Zoom. Thanks once again.
Okay, I also would like to thank you, Johnson, for sparing time and providing all these all these information about the cash flow concept in finance module. So
thank you, Ersan.
You are welcome. And now we have just arrived to the end. I will just count to three and then I'll just take a screenshot. One, two, and three. Okay. Thank you very much then. So this is all
Thank
for
you.
This week. See you in August once again.